Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm welcome to the Winter Gardens. I'm pleased to declare open this ceremony for the conferment of degrees and other higher awards on members of Blackpool and Defile College. We're here to celebrate the achievement of our graduands and to thank everyone who has helped you to reach this level of achievement. Many congratulations to you all. This is a high point in the college's year, and we're delighted to see so many people here this morning to share it with us. I think I'm told that there are about 1,700 people in the hall this morning, but yesterday held the record at about 2,000. I'm pleased to extend a particular welcome to our civic guests this morning, whose presence recognizes the importance of the college in this community of Blackpool and the Fylde area. And I'm delighted to welcome our guest of honour, Professor Andrew Atherton, Deputy Vice-Chancellor of Lancaster University, who will have the privilege of meeting you all and conferring your awards. Colleges like ours, however good they are, do not award their own degrees. They need a partnership with a university that has that power. We are proud of our long-standing relationship with the University of Lancaster. It's a university of high national and international standing, and it has a real concern that the degrees that it awards are of the highest quality. So, welcome to what is also a degree congregation of the university. Ladies and gentlemen, we are proud of our college. And we are proud of you, our graduands, this morning, and your achievements. Enjoy your day of celebration. And now, to give her address, please welcome the Principal and Chief Executive of the College, Bev Robinson.
Good morning. Ladies and gentlemen, may I begin by extending a very warm welcome to our distinguished guests from Education and Commerce, to graduates, their families and friends, and to colleagues at Blackpool and the Fylde College. I would also like to extend a very warm welcome to the Mayor and Mayoress of Wyre and the Mayor of Blackpool. Welcome to you all in what is a very important date on the college calendar. We are all here for the singular purpose of celebrating and acknowledging the success of you, our graduating students. On this memorable occasion, I would like us all please to pause and reflect upon the journey which has led to today. Some students will have planned to undertake a degree from a relatively young age and went through secondary school with that expectation. For others today, you will be the first in your family to have gained a degree and had thoughts that higher education would never be for you. Some of you have had a range of personal challenges, had busy jobs and families to care for, and you've juggled these commitments alongside your studies. You are all to be commended. On your journey to graduation, you've come to terms with the fact that having a particular aptitude or talent isn't enough to be successful. You've had to learn and master a whole new range of higher level thinking skills, developed stamina and determination, and gained a new understanding of your chosen field. But there is another ability which is equally important. And that's the ability to balance the ups and downs that are so characteristic of working life and still maintain a professionalism and that all-important drive and determination and passion to succeed. I think it would be an exceptional individual who hadn't at some point on their journey had doubts about their abilities or their choice of career. Doubts are a good thing. They make us question, they make us strive for the best solution or be the best that we can be. Questioning ourselves is a vital part of both academia and of working life. It's also important to question the perceived wisdom of our times and to remain open to new future possibilities and ways of working. We all know there will be jobs advertised in 5 years' time that no one has conceived of yet. So today, as you put aside the thoughts of lectures and seminars, of tutorials, of assignments, presentations, and reports, you lose the title of student, which many of you have held for several years. Now, as this new chapter of your life unfolds, you gain graduate professional status. You're a care professional, a manager, a teacher, a construction engineer, a sports coach, a hotel manager. Let me give you two pieces of advice which may be able to help you be successful in your working life. The first piece of advice comes from Steve Jobs, the co-founder of Apple. Your work is going to fill a large part of your life, and the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. Don't settle for anything less. Your time is limited, so don't waste it settling for second best. Have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. And a second piece of advice, which has also stood me in good stead. In whatever career you choose to follow, don't just hold yourself to high professional standards. Hold yourself to high ethical standards. You can see in the news, as one revelation after another unfolds, things won't always go smoothly in your career. But acting on principle and integrity will carry you through the tough times. People respect those with a clear moral compass. So today is all about celebrating success, your success. I am delighted and very proud to be here to witness this public acknowledgement of your achievements. I would like us also to pay tribute to those who have helped you on your journey to graduation, to the staff for their unstinting dedication, hard work, and commitment to your development, and for providing the right environment, opportunities, and stimulation for you to succeed. Thank you to the parents, relatives, and friends for all the support and encouragement that you have given. I also want to give a special thanks to the employers who have worked closely with the college, recognized the talent on offer, offered placements and employment, and often give that all-important first break to our students. So, graduands, I'd like you to stand up, please. I'd like you to look towards those people in your life who have contributed to your success here today and to show your appreciation in the time-honoured way. Thank you, if you'd like to take a seat. On behalf of my colleagues at Blackpool and the File College, I wish you every success. I trust your time as students with us has given you the confidence to get what you want, not just from your career, but from your life. I speak on behalf of all my colleagues when I say how proud we are of each and every one of you. We are delighted to be here to share in your celebrations, and I trust that today will be a day to remember. It now gives me great pleasure to invite Professor Andrew Atherton from Lancaster University to present the awards. Thank you.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Access and Continuing Education, Foundation Degree Literacies for Life.
Kelly Samantha Cocking. Suzanne Ellen Hargreaves. Katia Mary Lauder.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Business and Professional Studies, BA Honours Management in the Workplace.
Norman James Bishop. Carl Irwin. Greg Fothergill. Philip John Green. Carl Lee Hallam. Dane Joseph Highland. Elena Kazamankova. John Robert McKee. Kelly Amelia McNabb. Natalia Robertson. Zoe Thornton. Kaylee Wilson. Stephanie Danielle Jackson Wood.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Business and Professional Studies, Foundation Degree Accounting.
Angela Noel Bennison. Antonia Gail Trisha Berwick Ewing. Louise Jennifer Hillage. Dan Collins Radiodi.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Business and Professional Studies, Foundation Degree Management.
Maria Stefania Axanti. Amy Melvina Brailsford. Eloisa Marie Cheatham. Pavel Chilmanovich. Mark David Clare. Danielle Louise Dixon. Anton Stewart Gibson. Lisa Marie Hannigan. Jamie Leah Hindley. Tony Elizabeth James. Farhan Ashley Jones. Amanda Jane Laycock. Rhonda Michelle Masterton. Diane Joan McMinn. Luke James Milton Barker. Joanne Elizabeth Mould. Ebtihal Zuhair Mukhtar. Stevie Norris. Justina Pustelak. John Robert Simpson. Nicholas Paul Skibber. Caroline Jane Wolfe.
Deputy Vice Chancellor introducing students from the School of Business and Professional Studies, Executive Certificate in Management Studies.
Claire Burkett. Kelda Dearden. Neil Dwyer. Jeff Fillingham. Simon George. Shireen Herney. Michael Knight. Lee Parkin. Michael Spencer. Jason Taylor.
Deputy Vice Chancellor introducing students from the School of Business and Management Studies, CIPD Intermediate Diploma in Human Resource Management.
Susan Brown. Jacqueline Green. Sarah Hepworth. Beverly Ann Russell. Philip James Thompson. Haley Titterington. Kylie Elaine Wignall.
Deputy Vice Chancellor introducing students from the School of Business and Professional Studies, Professional Graduate Certificate in Education.
Linda Marie Aitken. Aminat Ali. Eleanor Benson. Emma Louise Benyon. Joseph Best. Haley Louise Borkin. Joanna Butler. Joanna Francesca Cassidy. Beverly Jane Cheatham. Sally Ann Cooper. Lynn Fantham. Amy Jane Harrison. Felicity Kate Howell. Davinia Jane Jackson. Daryl Ian Jenkins. Rachel Elizabeth Johnson. Andrew Lang. Donna Louise Victoria Lean. James Marcus Lees. Grant James Leach. Matthew Leslie. Paul John Moran. Rachel Francis Orwin. Saeed Anwar Parvez. Abigail Percival. Ryan James Robinson. Hayley Rowlings. Lindsay Saint. Daniel James Savage. Amber Jade Nikita Smith. Gillian Smith. Karen Teresa Whiteside. Helen Wilkinson.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Business and Professional Studies, Professional Certificate in Education.
Stacey Johnson. Stephen George Kirkham. Christopher Hindman. Maxwell Harvey Lacks. James Peter Loy. Lisa Joanne Mills. Charlotte Helen Maggie Parkinson. Carl David Pixton. Donna Marie Redford. Daniel Rossi. Rosalind Sang. Stuart John Turner. Lucy Catherine Williams.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Business and Professional Studies, Diploma in Teaching in the Lifelong Learning Sector.
Gwen Hunt. Janine Pollard.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Business and Professional Studies, Diploma in Therapeutic Counselling.
Claire Boardman. Claire Martin. Angela Elizabeth Pipe.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Business and Professional Studies, Certificate in Teaching in the Lifelong Learning Sector.
Mark Wayne Clulo. Philip Paul. Adam Peter Robinson.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing the students from the School of Construction, HNC Construction.
Alec Dominic Aiken. Alex Jeffrey Barnsley. Kieran Bezick. Amy Lee Bond. Robert John Chesney. James Simon Dobson. Kane Alexander Hadgraft. Drew Tyler Smith. Michael Joseph Woods.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Hairdressing, Beauty and Related Therapies, HND Beauty Therapy Sciences.
Emma Candlin. Sharon Kenyon Jenkins. Aileen McLaughlin. Zarina Punzo.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Hospitality, Tourism and Sport, BA Honours Hospitality Management.
Hannah Charlotte Appleyard. Sophie Charlotte Bradley. Jodie Ann Collins. Marissa Laura Fitzsimmons. Helen Marie Gisborne. Sarah Frances Hitchin. Vladislav Kunis. Amy Faith Lambert. Jodie Marsh. Paul David McGarry. Amanda Jane Sandy. Chantelle Louise Vickers. Deborah Maria Woods. Amy Louise Wright.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Hospitality, Tourism and Sport, BA Honours International Resort Tourism Management.
Kirsty Ann Boff. Tracy Alma Hilton. Rosie Ellis Antonia Brothwood. Grace Johnson.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Hospitality, Tourism and Sport, BA Honours Hospitality Management, International Hotel Management.
Danielle Anthony. Stephanie Jane Hume. Jade Leslie Rimner. Alana Rose Williams.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Hospitality, Tourism and Sport, BA Honours, Sports Studies and Development.
Stephen Matthew Brown. Samuel Jacob Dennis Dyer. James Christopher Michael Heaton.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Hospitality, Tourism and Sport, BSc Honours Sports Coaching.
Daniel Andrew Bracegirdle. Christian Dixon. Laura Stephanie Elizabeth Dolan. Craig Lawrence Gillies. Daniel Gorman. Glenn Joseph Martland. Mark Christopher Robinson. Dean James Webb. Nigel Barry John Wilding.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Hospitality, Tourism and Sport, Foundation Degree Events Management.
Claire Marie Crooks. Darren James Fox. Adrian Hoyle. Cara Louise Metcalf. Elizabeth Joyce Smart. Katie Rose Nelligan. Hannah Rogerson. Joanna Louise Scott. Amy Christine Sturge.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Hospitality, Tourism and Sport, Foundation Degree Hospitality and Licensed Retail Management.
John Farrell. Louise Harrison. Lindsay Marie Hunt. Gavin Christopher Mathams. Andre James McKellar. Alan Moon. Magdalena Paulina Smolan.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Hospitality, Tourism and Sport, Foundation Degree, Sports Coaching.
Christian Hamer. Carl Matthew Heatley. Ryan Andrew Lee.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Hospitality, Tourism and Sport, Foundation Degree, Sports Studies and Development.
Yvonne Liana Aspie. Adam Jacob Leonard Chamberlain. Jamie Gunn. Jonathan Houston. Scott Alexander Kemp. Scott Alexander McNeil. Shannon Lauren McAdam. Stephen Wardle.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Hospitality, Tourism and Sport, Foundation Degree, Travel and Tourism Management.
Thank you. Carol Baranowski. Christopher Michael Davis. Laura Delaney. Emma Victoria Farah. Samantha Holmes. Nicola Jane Lamb. Holly Ruth Ledbetter. Zoe Lee. Katie Louise Making. Sarah Jane Priestley. Thomas James Alexander Robinson. Holly Paula Strother.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Hospitality, Tourism and Sport, HND Public Services.
Alex Beeston. Daniel Martin Johnson. Holly Louise Staley Shaw.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Society, Health and Childhood, BA Honours, Early Childhood Studies.
Alison Fiona Buttle. Nicole Eileen Ann Grimston. Emma Hakawi. Lana Ingham. Claire Lorraine Cairns. Laura Katrina Leite. Amy Joanna Lyon. Claire Elizabeth Potter. Samantha Jane Shepherd.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Society, Health and Childhood, BA Honours, Health and Social Care, Adult.
Helen Marie Abbott. Anna Brady. Lisa Mary Brown. Karen Dawn Cropper. Sarah Louise Gregory. Nicola Jane Lewis. Normat Mihaly Mate. Charlotte Ruth Morrison. Sifindili Unluva.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Society, Health and Childhood, BA Honours, Health and Social Care, Child.
Victoria Jane Aldred. Katie Elizabeth Ansell. Zana Chowdhury. Adam Matthew Hawes. Emma Louise Kirkham. Teresa Mary Knighton. Michael Kent Newbold. Catherine Alice Vernon. Carolyn Jane Watkins. Samantha Jane Wilkinson.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Society, Health and Childhood, BA Honours, Health and Social Care, Substance Misuse.
Thank you. Chalita Housby Moyle. Victoria Ann Smith.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Society, Health and Childhood, BA Honours, Teaching and Learning, Primary.
Helen Brady. Lauren Jane Brooks. Stephanie Darch. Sophie Farrer. Samantha Ann Mulvey. Nicola Lindsay Rigby. Victoria Jane Walsh. Erica Jane Walwin. Jessica Rose Wiley.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Society, Health and Childhood, Foundation Degree, Managing Drug and Alcohol Misuse.
Peter Hornsby. Rebecca Thurlow. Joanne Worrell.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Society, Health and Childhood, Foundation Degree, Professional Practice, Early Years.
Leanne Michelle Alsop. Husna Begum. Natalie Ann Bell. Rachel Leslie Bolton. Michelle Louise Burton. Emily Victoria Klimmer. Sarah Cornell. Maureen Bridget Gargan. Kylie Gregson. Lisa Marie Hill. Sophie Lauren Hornby. Leanne Carly Johnston. Rebecca Kibler. Christine Louise Kekamoa. Sorry. Melanie Victoria Lang. Kirsty Maria Lillico. Stacey Louise Madden. Rachel Jane McGee. Sarah Mears. Victoria Louise Potter. Judy Ann Runciman. Lisa Ann Sturzica. Lisa Ann Taylor. Caroline Turner. Robin Anna Whiteside.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Health, of Society, Health and Childhood, Foundation Degree, Professional Practice, Health and Social Care.
Beverly Dawn Abbas. Dorota Abratanska. Charlotte Victoria Bates. Shannon Beavers. Melanie Maria Berry. Rachel Louise Byrne. Rachel Louise Cherry. Antoinette Colton. Samantha Jane Dean. Stacey Louise Fennell. Leanne Denise Green. Laura Ann Sylvia Hartley. Angela Mary Sutherland. Kerry Trevelyan. Barbara Winterbottom.
Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Society, Health and Childhood, Foundation Degree, Teaching and Learning Support, Primary.
Terry Ann Ball. Anastasia Bartlett. Lisa Marie Bennison. Poppy Blundell. Hannah Bullock. Michelle Byrne. Joanna Louise Hessen Carter. Sally Michelle Coker. Vanessa Ann Finlayson. Josephine Mary Lloyd. Timea Mate Ronier. Amy Rebecca Mary Murphy. Lindsay Ann Nelligan. Helen Paddock. Alexandra Rose Denise Palmer. Mark Rimmer. Naomi Elizabeth Warburton. Sophie Elizabeth Whitworth. Jacqueline Helen Winslow.
The Deputy Vice Chancellor, introducing students from the School of Society, Health and Childhood, Foundation Degree, Working with Young People in the Community.
Kimberly Linda Archer. Linda Tracy Baldwin. Tracy Beveridge. Alison Clark. Karina Ann Clark. Siobhan Maria Crouch. Sophia Morgan. Sarah Murphy. Mark Edward Parkinson. Lindsay Michelle Timmins. Jade Michelle Trainer. Solene Zodros. Can I ask the graduands to all stand, please?
Thank you.
I'd now like to invite the Deputy Vice Chancellor to confer your awards.
By my authority as Deputy Vice Chancellor, I confer upon these members of Blackpool and the Fylde College the awards for which they have been presented. Well done.
Thank you. Can the graduates now sit down, please? And can I invite the Deputy Vice-Chancellor to say a few words?
Members of the College, guests and now graduates, it gives me great pleasure to be here at Blackpool and the Fylde College at this great celebration of your success. I'm well aware that on a day like this, and at this point in the celebrations, the one thing you probably require from me, first and foremost, is economy in my speech. So, I shall try not to fail you in that respect. There are exactly 44 sentences in this speech, three of which you have just heard. The remaining 41, hopefully, will fly by. May I start by taking the opportunity to express my sincere congratulations to you, our graduates. Achieving an award is no mean feat, but you have succeeded in doing so from one of the UK's very best universities, and you can justifiably be proud of that achievement. Today's ceremony is a fitting tribute, and I am very proud to be here to recognise and celebrate your accomplishments, the fruits of years of hard work. It marks both the end of one chapter and the beginning of another. For the college, of course, but especially in the lives of you, today's graduates, each one of you has travelled different paths to get to this point, a journey that's been shared and supported by many people, your family, your friends, and your fellow students, as the principal has said. And we are delighted that you're all here for these celebrations. Today's ceremony is also an opportunity to reflect upon the success of the partnership between Lancaster University and Blackpool and the Fylde College. Lancaster validated programmes have been offered at the college since September 1992, with the first class of 17 students graduating in July 1993 from the Bachelor of Arts Hotel, Catering and Institutional Management programme. Since then, our partnership has gone from strength to strength, with around 1,000 students graduating this year from 60 different Lancaster validated programmes. Although we are a university with global reach, Lancaster values its local links to the immediate and wider Northwest region. We're committed to bringing Lancaster awards to a much broader audience, widening participation in higher education, especially through our partnership with Blackpool and the Fylde College. We attach great importance to the regeneration of the Blackpool area and the offer of further and higher education within it. Looking forward to 2013-14, Lancaster, in collaboration with its regional colleges, will be investing further in promoting the progression of underrepresented groups from colleges and local communities to higher education through academic taster sessions, mentoring schemes, and residential programs designed to inspire, motivate, build confidence, and enhance learning. I'd like to take this opportunity to extend a special word of thanks to Blackpool and Fylde's former principal, Pauline Waterhouse, for all the hard work and dedication through this collaboration, and we wish her all the success in the future. I'd also like to say hello and welcome to the new principal of the college, Bev Robinson. I'd also like to share and celebrate some of Lancaster University's recent achievements resulting from our commitment to four key priorities: producing world-class research, transforming people's lives and society through teaching and learning, engaging with business and our communities, and developing our culture and values. The reputation of Lancaster is unequivocal. We have consolidated our position as one of the best of the UK universities, being in the top 10 in many of the major UK league tables. We've also established ourselves in the top 1% of universities worldwide, a very remarkable achievement for a university yet to celebrate its 15th anniversary, which will be next year in 2014. Our excellent results in the National Student Survey, a testament to the commitment of both staff and students in making the university a place where students want and compete to study. Lancaster's top 10 ranking in the Times Higher Education Survey of Student Experience supports and provides evidence of this commitment. And the value placed on a Lancaster degree becomes clear when you talk to employers about the desirability of graduates from Lancaster in one of the most competitive graduate job markets we've ever known. As a world-class research institution, I could tell you about many different research projects and achievements over the last year, but I'm going to focus on two, the first being the opening of the Centre for Corpus Approaches to Social Science, which brings a new method in studying language to a range of social sciences. This approach gives insight into how language is used in society in areas such as climate change, hate crime, and education. And the second achievement is the new Cross-Faculty Research Centre Demand, which looks at the use and demand for energy. It's a £5 million centre in collaboration with seven other university partners. We hope that this centre will provide invaluable advice and insight for organisations involved in energy right the way through to greenhouse gas emissions and targets reduction. As a university, we take responsibility for protecting the environment. Improved environmental performance and the implementation of various projects, including, for example, the wind turbine you can now see from the M6, has helped the university move towards its vision of a more sustainable campus. With the commitment of staff and students, we've reduced emissions and impacts over the last year. But today, we're celebrating your achievement, your graduation. Sharing in your celebrations are your family, friends, partners, and children. Their support, moral, emotional, and most likely financial as well. And also their encouragement through the difficult times will have played a crucial role in achieving the successes that we celebrate today. And I'd like to echo Bev's earlier request that you recognise those who've supported you today. So your degree is a hugely important milestone, and you should really celebrate your accomplishments today and in the future. It is your day to remember, so celebrate it, enjoy it. No doubt your parties will extend beyond this ceremony, and there'll be much merriment. You have earned it, and we wish you a truly wonderful and joyful day of celebration. May I again, on behalf of us all, congratulate you and wish you all success in your future lives. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Norbert Maid, from the School of Society, Health and Childhood at the Blackpool and the Flight College. I live in Fleetwood and being a working father of two boys. I had to cope with the pressure of studying, work and family life. I feel very proud of the fact that I have successfully completed my BA Honours in Health and Social Care. It's been a collective family effort, and I would like to thank my fantastic family, both supporting and helping me throughout this educational journey. It's been a hard to reach this milestone and personal achievement, but my learning experience have been supported by some fantastic friends I've made, both personally and professionally. On behalf of all my fellow students, I would like to thank the following people for today's memorable event. Firstly, the Winter Garden for providing such a fantastic venue, ensuring that today is a day we will all cherish. Thank you to the marketing department and all those involved in organizing the event, because everybody knows these events don't happen just overnight. On everyone's behalf, I would like to thank Bev Robinson, College Principal and Chief Executive, and also Professor Andrea Thurton from Lancaster University for being here today and presenting us with our well-earned awards. A huge thanks to our lecturers for sharing their knowledge and experience, and also for their support and guidance. We couldn't have achieved what we have without them. I'm sure you will join me in showing our appreciation for them. The most important thank you must go to our parents, family, friends and colleagues who deserve many thanks for all the support, both emotionally and financially, during our time at the college. I'm sure they will all agree today that it was worth it. And this event is as much a celebration for them as for us. So fellow graduates, please join me in thanking them for all their support. And finally, I would like to congratulate my fellow students on all their achievement, hard work and commitment, and I'm sure many of you, like me, have gained much from your time here at the college. You will carry these valuable experiences throughout your life, and as we know, return to the big wide world seeking employment in our particular fields, I would like to wish all of you the best of luck and much success in the future, whatever you decided to do. And could I please ask everyone to remain seated until the stage part and the guests have left the ballroom, after which we would like you to join us for a refreshment in the arena.